Ahoy, this is Zdenka. Here's the first one. I tried to film a cinematic video yesterday, except it didn't turn out to be that cinematic. Another one. Help! How come my videos are not looking like yours? And third one. I'm struggling framing the shot. I completely understand what you're talking about. I'm going to try to help in this video. Let's talk about framing and composition and how to get your videos look a little bit more cinematic that way. Instead of me telling you rule one, rule two, rule three, I decided to pull out some of the clips I filmed in the past, some of the videos I filmed in the past, and I'm gonna try to go through those clips individually and tell you exactly why I framed those videos, why I did what I did, and give you some extra tips so you can reach a little bit more cinematic look. And for the new faces, welcome. My name is Zdenka Darula. If you want to learn how to take better photos and videos with the latest gear and possibly participate in creative camera challenges, consider subscribing. First of all, when I get to location, whether I'm filming outside or I'm filming indoors, even a product shot, few things are always the same. I never shoot just with one lens. If I'm filming with smartphone, I take advantage of the other lenses. If I'm filming with my mirrorless camera, then I bring extra lenses. I like to get a mixture of wide shots, medium shots, and close-up shots. When I'm framing my shot, I'm doing exactly the same thing like in photography. It doesn't matter if I'm taking photos or I'm doing videos, I'm doing the same thing. Let's look at the first four clips. They have two things in common: balance and symmetry. What you don't want to do is leaving a clutter of stuff on one side and then leaving an empty room on the other. The first shot of a tree going from a birdhouse slowly down, revealing house on the left and model on the right, gives a sense of balance. Both sides are balanced properly, they're balancing the scene, tree is dividing the middle. Second clip of a makeup artist. Here I wanted to see her expression as she's fully concentrating on what she is doing. I could have just filmed her face, but then I would not tell the whole story. I needed to see the model as well to complete the story. I still kept only her face fully in focus, so the attention is on her. However, placing her on the left and model on the right side made the shot well balanced. And I do this in any type of view. If I'm filming forward, if I'm filming down up or from above, here's the same scene. Makeup artist with model, both of them on each side balancing the shot. This time I have them both in focus because I'm not seeing the face, I'm not seeing the action, but I'm showing entire scene, the whole action, what is going on. So in this case, I have to have everybody in focus. Baseball field is a perfect example of symmetry. Boring object, an ugly object like benches can look interesting. I made sure everything is very symmetrical and straight lines. Just circling from bottom up, revealing the scene behind it. What I find that if I have a beautiful natural scene, then I do very nice, beautiful shot. But if there's something very ugly in it, that can totally break the look. So I actually go, like I said, very close to the object, the ugly object, and try to do something creative around it, go very close to it to reveal what's behind it. And then I found different angles so I don't actually see that ugly object in the whole shot. Next three clips are all about horizon. They teach you in the books that when you pull out on the screen the great rule of thirds, it looks like that, then your horizon should be perfectly on the lower lane or on the upper lane. Well, I don't exactly do it always that way. I use my own judgment and choose what scene really looks good, what I really like in the video or photos. In the first clip, I do have the end of the lake closer to the top line. However, what made my decision was the tall green grass in the front, which is nicely in focus. I wanted to see most of it, and I also like the rocks and water at the bottom of the grass. Second clip was shot with my cell phone, has horizon pretty much in the middle. I get very low. I never shoot in the mid-range. I always go very low if I'm doing landscape like this. Third clip has a very low horizon, but that was not the intention. I simply wanted to see the whole light, which is lighting up the whole baseball area. Whenever you film or take photos of horizon, you want to make sure it is perfectly leveled. You don't want to go like this. And I know it's not easy when you film handheld, or even if you are filming with gimbals, some of the gimbals are not perfectly balanced. Even if you do calibration, sometimes it's still a little bit tiny off. If you don't have a further settings in the menu, then you can't really fix it up. Luckily, in the post, when you're editing your videos, in the programs like Adobe Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve, which is free, you should try it out, are options there where you can certainly level it up. Leading lanes can be straight or they can be curved, and they are leading your eyes towards the object in the middle. And it can be anywhere. It can be fence, it can be path, it can be road, it can be alley of the trees, all kinds of stuff. First clip is showing a huge staircase with railing. What I did is getting close to one side, leading the railing as I was stepping forward. Next shot is just following the curve of the skates. And lighthouse time lapse. Shape of the ground follows us to the lighthouse. And lastly, here I was circling this tall pole as close as I could. The shape was leading us to the lights. The next three clips have a lot to do with depth of field, but first let's talk about shooting through stuff. Whenever I want to create a mystery or candid moment, I choose to shoot through something. Tall grass, branches, anything in a way, making sure that the foreground, those branches, the tall grass is nice and blurry, and the object or whatever I want to see behind it is nicely sharp. If I don't have anything like that available, then I literally just grab a leaf, stick it right in front of my lens to the corner, and take a shot or video like that. Plus, sometimes it also creates a sense of balance. For example, if there's a lot of stuff on the right side, but I feel that this area is just way too empty, if I bring that leaf in or something in the foreground in, it will actually balance the shot way better. Here's one clip shooting through grass to show sunset. Another one here is shot through grass as well, revealing a woman looking at passing by boat. Here is a sense of candidness. It's a very candid shot. And then another one is shooting through grass one more time. For that though, you need to select right aperture or the depth of field and select the right lenses as well. I actually created a video shooting in aperture priority mode, and I also created another video about 50 millimeters prime lens. I'm gonna link it below the video in the video description. That can be helpful. You can watch it after this. So whenever you're shooting these kind of things, you want to make sure your aperture is very low, and the best lenses you can get is prime lens, 50 millimeter lens, or telephoto will work as well. First shot here is set at low aperture f2.8. Close-up shots of the leaves with 50 millimeters prime lens. Rock with water passing by. This was done with telephoto lens, also low aperture, set to f2.8 as well. Another one is close-up of a hand. Here I actually placed a bit the hand on the left, not in the middle. And close-up of a face. Make sure that whenever you are filming a face, you always focus on eyes. Eyes need to be sharp. Speaking of not placing the object right in the middle, there's something called the rule of thirds. Let me pull out that grid one more time. Basically, where those intersections meet at those spots, that's where you want to place the object. It just makes it very attractive to the eye. Well, obviously, I don't always place exactly the objects on those intersections. Again, I use my own judgment. I place it maybe close to it, but not always there. I see the overall scene and I just leave it the way I like it. In the first shot, she's a bit closer to the center, but to me, it looked kind of right. Also, make sure person's face is facing center of the image, not outside. The same thing goes with the sunset shot. I also didn't place her exactly to the side, but a bit more in her center. I simply like the curves and the shapes of the tall grass. What I wanted is the sun shining through to be the exact center. I hope this video helped you to start seeing the compositions a little bit easier in the future videos. I hope it did. Hit the thumbs up if you found this video useful, and don't forget to subscribe to all future videos like these. If you have any questions, comments, simply want to say hi or ahoy, or if you want to suggest a topic, you want me to create a video about a certain thing, please don't be afraid to write it in the comment section below, and I'll see you, my friends, in the next video. Ciao. Ahoy.